Alright, let's do an integral battle. Haven't done this for a while, so here's one for you guys. The first integral is the integral of 1 minus 1 over x squared times e to the x plus 1 of x. And the second one is 1 plus x minus 1 over x times e to the x plus 1 over x power. As always, please pause the video and try them first. Done? Which one's easier? That one, right? So let's finish that first. Well, notice that 1 minus 1 over x squared happens to be the derivative of x plus 1 over x. So this can be done with u sub. Go ahead, let u equal to x plus 1 over x. And then you see du is just 1. And the derivative of this is minus 1 over x squared. And we have the dx. So as you can see, this and that together is our du. Therefore, this is just the integral of e to the u in the u world. Cool. And then integral of e to the u is just e to the u. So we have e to the u. And u is what? U is that. So let's put down x plus 1 over x power. And we are done. Plus c. Cool. Yeah, plus c. All right. Now, this right here is trickier because, of course, this is not the derivative of that. So what do we do? Any suggestions? Integration by parts, maybe you could. But wouldn't it be nice if we can somehow squeeze out the derivative of x plus 1 over x? Yeah. If we can somehow squeeze out the 1 minus 1 over x squared, that would be kind of nice, right? We do have the 1 and also the minus 1 over x, but I want to have the x to the second power on the bottom though. So what do we do? Well, have a look. In fact, I don't want to pair this and that together. Rather, I'll just pair this up together. I can actually squeeze out that if we factor out an x from here. Check this out. This right here equals the integral. 1 is still 1, but I will say plus x right here times, now we have the 1. We factor out the x. This right here will be minus 1 over x squared. Cool. And then times e to the x plus 1 over x power dx. And now what? Let's distribute, right? So this right here is the integral. Let me put this down like this for you guys, right? I am going to put this down times that, this times that. So we have x times this, e to the x plus 1 over x. I don't want to use the parentheses. Let me just put that down. But times this guy, 1 minus 1 over x squared. Aha, some of you can see what's going on already, right? Yeah. And then plus this times that, so just e to the x plus 1 over x dx. All right? So in fact, you have a few ways to do it. If you can just look at this and you're pretty much done. Because the answer is what? This right here is just x times e to the x plus 1 over x power. And you're done. Plus c. Do you see it? Right. If today we differentiate x times e to the x plus 1 over x power, what do we do? The product rule. First one, I will keep it. That's why I keep it like this earlier. I keep the first one and then I multiply by the derivative. I keep the first one and I'll multiply by the derivative of the second. So that will be e to the... I keep the first one and I'll multiply by the derivative of the second. And that will be e to the x. You just keep that, right? E to the whatever, just maintain that. And then you multiply by the derivative of this, which will give us 1 minus 1 over x squared. Yeah. And then you add the second term, which is e to the x plus 1 over x power times the derivative of the first, which is just a 1, which doesn't matter. So as you can see, this right here checks. This right here checks. So that's pretty much it. And of course, some of you guys know a formula whenever you have e to the whatever times the function plus the derivative function. Yeah, I would love to write down the formula for you guys, but I don't think the board is big enough. So that's it.